Hello everyone, I am Akhilesh and I will be talking about active learning, a concept in machine learning. So let us say that you have a lot of data to label and you want to do a machine learning algorithm on a big amount of data, but you don't have any labeled data. You have a very small amount or no labeled data and labeling each sample is very expensive. So what will you do now? So that is what active learning is about. It is a concept which you can use to label data optimally and still get good results after labeling less data. Now let us look at what active learning is. So the key idea behind active learning is that a machine learning algorithm can perform better with less training if it is allowed to choose the data on its own. This was said in an active learning survey by Settles, and basically what they mean is the machine learning algorithm itself should choose what data to label so that it can perform optimally. So it will choose the best data so that it can get the results fast and good with very less amount of labeling. Now the steps in active learning are: first, the model is trained on the labeled data, whatever small amount of labeled data is. Then it is evaluated on the unlabeled samples, and based on this evaluation it chooses the best samples to label, best unlabeled samples to label, so that it can increase its labeled data size. When all these are added to the labeled data, the training data size increases. It retrains and continues the process over time so that it can slowly increase the trained data, but the main objective being it can get a good performance with less amount of data labeling. An important component here is an oracle. An oracle is a person or something that knows the correct answer or the correct classification to all the samples or the correct answer to all the questions and queries. Practically, an oracle is an expert in that field or would be an algorithm, but it would be expensive to run the algorithm or to consult the person. Thus, we are using active learning to reduce the number of labeling needed. Let us now look at an example for active learning. Now, this is the data set that is given to us. There are many green points and red points. However, we do not know any of the points and how they are labeled. We basically know all the points, but we don't know any of the labels. And we let us say that we randomly label some of the points. We may end up with something like this or something like this, where the ones shown in green and red are the labeled ones and all the smaller dots are the unlabeled points. So when we look at something like this, when we do a random labeling, we see that it can come in any fashion and may not necessarily be a good fit if we use random point. So you can see that this is the decision boundary for the two classes, and if we have the ideal boundary would actually be somewhere like this, which is close to this. But if you do a random labeling, in some case you may get too many green points. So if you label 20 random points, there may be 17 or 18 green points and one or two red points, and you'll get a very bad line. Maybe the line would be something like that, or like a really bad line. And in only very small cases, you'll get a line that is very close to what is supposed to be. And in active learning, it actually helps you in a way that it'll reach you, it'll make you go to this line with very less labeling of points. So now let us just look at an example. So let us say that you have these points here and these points. So next, what it'll do is it'll have to find the best point to label so that it can get a good fit the next time. So the best point would be what is the most uncertain point now. We'll try to label that so that that one will become more certain. You get a lot of information. So it may label some points here very close to the line. So yes, that is how active learning works, and it keeps it adds that to the data point pool and it goes ahead building new models and it repeats the iterations. I have written an article on active learning on Towards Data Science, which is a part of medium.com. You can check this out and implement it for better understanding. It is an active learning tutorial in Python, and it has explanations for each of the parts of the code. For further reading, you can check out this article on datacam.com and this article on Wikipedia. Both these have good amount of details on active learning. I've added all these links in the description, and I've also added my other references in the description. You can check all these out for further reading. Thank you. And if you like the video, hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe and hit the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.